Palmer.
Pass, S.O.G.
This vocal duo once sang under the name of Tom and
Simon Jerry, and Garfunkel, right? F.L.
Might be translated as dirty money.
Pass, O.T.H.
When you make an exact statement, this is where you hit the nail.
On the head, correct? S.A.D.
The natural law that governs prices.
Pass, O.E.T.
Famous British lexicon.
Oxford English Dictionary.
Yes.
F.T.A.N.
Do battle, even using your mouths and hands. Do battle.
Bite tooth and nail.
Yes.
B.L.
Versatile young actress played Violet Elizabeth in Just William.
Bonnie Langford.
Yes, that's the connection. Oh, that's tremendous. You had me going there for a moment, as you possibly heard. You get terribly excited. This is what you've won. Listen to this.
Felicity and Effie of George Abbott School each take home one of these superb stereo music centres.
Well, what a marvellous start. Stereo Music Centre for each of them. A great start in their first gold run. She just made it. There was a few seconds to spare, but she did very well indeed. How are you feeling now? Better?
It's longer than you think, isn't it?
It is, yes. It does take a lot longer than you think, except when you can't get the answers. Right, we're going into the first game of a set of three now, so we're going to introduce our reigning champions to a new contestant. Let's see then who next is going to play Blockbusters. Well, David, welcome. Where have you come from, Dave?
Chorley in Lancashire.
In Lancashire, I can tell immediately. Which school do you go to?
Renshaw College, Leyland.
And what are you good at school?
If anything, economics.
Rotten question. Oh, economics, interesting. What do you want to do eventually? Have you got an eventual ambition?
I'd like to be a journalist, I think.
That's an interesting profession. It's a dodgy one at times, but it's an interesting one. Welcome to the programme, Dave. And girls, all ready for the first game in another set of three?
Yeah.
Could be another gold run at the end of it. They are. You can see the confidence growing all the time. £95 each they have, as well as a music centre each. And this is the board for the first game in a set of three. We are going to play Blockbusters. And H is the question with which we start. This is it. What H is a vehicle, especially for carrying a body to the grave?
Hearse.
Yes, David, it's a hearse. Well started, that's it. And your choice for the next one.
J, please. B, please.
You want B? Okay. What B is the national field game of the USA? Felicity?
Baseball.
Is right. Baseball, one of each. Your choice.
D, please.
You want D? Here it is. What D is sweet and grows on palms in North Africa? Hey, everybody. Felicity?
Dates.
Dates is right. Date, yes. And the next?
P. P, please.
They choose P, which is in the middle to tie up those other two. Here we go. What P is the five-sided building which...
Pentagon. Pentagon.
Yes, fine. Pentagon it is. Well done. And it's your choice, Dave.
F, please.
F at the bottom there. Rattling along, and here we go. What F is produced by yeast and is often... That's Felicity. Time up. I have to give it to David. What F is produced by yeast and is often recognised by frothing?
Fermentation.
Yes, you've got it right on the dot. Fermentation, he said. I heard him right on the dot. That's it. And he gives you the choice for the next one.
M, please.
Yes, M, and the flashing light meant that if you get this, you make that connection top to bottom, unless it's blocked. M it is. What M is a sort of shoe based on the soft deerskin footwear of the... Yes, David?
Moccasin.
Moccasin is right, and that's it. He's quick, isn't he?
Yeah.
You looked a bit disgruntled about something, Felicity. All right.
I knew fermentation, but I didn't understand the word of the question.
Yes, I see. You interrupted before I got to the end, Felicity.
I'm just being stupid.
Well, never mind. Fermentation. I thought you'd know fermentation, knowing your habits. So there we are. Okay. Oh, yes, we do talk. Felicity and Effie, you're now defending your challenge, your actual record so far against a challenger sitting next to you, David, who's very fast on the button. So, they've got to watch this. David, you're feeling okay now?
Yes, thanks.
You're actually looking very calm. It's a bit worrying. So, here we go to the second game of the set of three. G it is, flashing on the right-hand side. Everybody stand by the buttons as fast as you can with this one. What G is the first book of the Old Testament?
Genesis.
Genesis is right, yes. Where next?
A, please.
N.
A.
A, sorry. That A does give us problems. Yeah. What A whiz round in orbits between Mars and Jupiter? Yes, Felicity.
Asteroids.
Asteroids is right. Yes, would one. Thank goodness that A is out. Now, what are we going to do next?
B, please. Oh, what do you want?
F.
Oh, okay, F.
Well, don't fight. F it is in the top there, right? What F is a gigantic vertical revolving wheel seen at...
Ferris.
Yes, Ferris wheel it is. And the next.
L, please.
L, in the middle. Right. Good one. What L was the mad king of Bavaria who was a friend of Wagner's? Yes, David?
Lohengrin.
No, no, but it's worth interrupting for, or worth having a go at. What L was the mad king of Bavaria who was a friend of Wagner's? Girls, do you know? Ludwig is the answer. Ludwig. So we go for another L. Not the L. What L was a famous siege in the Boer War? Yes, you did that in history at school, didn't you? Yes, I know, from the Jameson raid last week. What L was a famous siege in the Boer War? It was Ladysmith. Right. What L is the humpless member of the camel family found in South America? Yes, David?
Llama.
Llama's right, yes, good. Okay, let's have another.
S, please.
You'll have S right down at the bottom. What S was the capital city in Central Africa, now called Harare? Yes, David?
Salisbury.
Salisbury's right. That's another good one. And again, the light's flashing. You could win this one if it's not blocked. You've got the chance. One unit to go. Which one?
B, please.
B? A predictable one, but the wise one to pick. What B is a shrub and a singer? David?
Basil.
No, it's a nice idea. It's not a shrub, though. What B is a shrub and a singer? I have to give it to the other two. Kate? Bush.
Bush.
Ah. B again. What B is what you put in a mouse trap or on a fish hook? Good heavens, yes.
Bait.
Yes, it's bait, right? Well, without any ado at all. That's it. David, you've got two games in a row. Very well done indeed. I never expected it to happen as quickly as that. In fact, they gave me the idea they were settled in for good, you two. It looks as though we've got to say goodbye to you, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Very sad. Yeah. Thought you were... Overconfidence, perhaps. The nerves went and you started to get overconfident. What was it? Tell us why it happened.
I think he's too quick on the gas.
It's as simple as that, is it?
Yeah. Yeah.
Well, you take with you £110 each, and of course they take with them a stereo music centre each. It's been smashing having you on the programme. Felicity and Effie, the best of luck, and thank you very much indeed.
Thank you.
Well, our fast mover David is now going to go in for a gold run. We'll be showing him the board in just a moment, and we'll see how what he will be winning, if he does, in the first of the gold run major prizes. All that in just a moment. Come back soon.
Look, lunch is over, so this is over.
Whoa, whoa, is this a breakup? Is this a breakup?
Shh, don't make this any harder.
Well, I'm not leaving.
Break up with lingering food. Help keep teeth clean and healthy.
Eat, drink, chew.
Extra.
Freedom for the taking. Blue e-cigarettes and e-liquids.
Four! Do you think I hit her?
She's fine.
Hey, it's Claire. I hate to spoil your golf game, but I'm pregnant.
What?
Let's talk as soon as you can.
I have to leave.
What? We're in the middle of a game.
I have to be with Claire.
My clubs. My hat.
Catch up with the new series of Modern Family on demand now.
I'm a red that supports green, and I believe in protecting the environment. Because with an area the size of 3 football pitches lost in the Amazon every minute, it's time for each and every one of us to play our part. Just making small changes to our daily lives could make a real difference to the rainforest. Sky and WWF are working together to help save 1 billion trees in the Amazon. Why not find out what you can do? Visit sky.com/rainforest rescue and show the Amazon some love. Sky, believe in better.
Welcome back, and thank you very much indeed. It's always a bit grim luck for the one contestant who's left and has to take the gold run when we say, well, he'll take it in a minute, we're going to leave you for now, because he's got a couple of minutes to sweat, and he's been doing just that, haven't you, David? Been sitting there. You feel all right, though, don't you? You're okay.
Not too bad.
Yeah, not too bad, I thought so. Let's just tell you a little about the gold run, as though I need to, but one has to. It is, of course, the first gold run that David's taken, and it can mean that he goes right up to the fifth. It depends on how he gets on in this one, of course. But winning this one, or losing it, does not preclude him from carrying on with the normal blockbuster games, as we'll be seeing. We take a look at the board he's going to play on. Here they are, the multiple letters. That's the gold connection he has to make. Not necessarily that one. He can make this one if he likes. But, of course, as we all know by this time, he has to make that connection in 60 seconds or less. 60 seconds or less. And if he does that, he wins one of the major prizes in Blockbuster. So, let's ask you now, David, if you will, if you're all ready, to take your place on the hotspot, please. That connection, David, has got to be made gold to gold in 60 seconds or less. If you don't make the connection, you get £10 for each correct answer anyway. And I take my timing, as you well know, from the letters you choose on the left-hand side. Over to you.
CN.
Monolith from Egypt, now on the Thames Embankment.
Cleopatra's Needle, correct. NL.
Another name for Aurora Borealis.
Northern Lights.
Right.
AM.
Author of The Misfits.
Pass. YCNC.
Lord Kitchener's message on his recruiting poster.
Your country needs you. ET. Yeah.
Child who embarrasses his elders with untimely remarks.
Enfant terrible.
Yes.
DD.
Famous racing picture by Frith.
Pass. JWB.
Man who caused the death of Abraham Lincoln.
Pass. ASQ.
4 chamber musicians who've been together for 35 years and sound as if they loved God.
Pass. AOY.
Primate of England.
Archbishop of York.
Yes.
SH.
One of French Emperor's homes. One of the French Emperor's homes.
St. Helena.
Yes, it is. That's the connection. Well done. Oh, that was tense. There was quite a lot of tension there, wasn't there? The only reason I hesitated at the end is it's pronounced St. Helena, which you said St. Helena. It was the right answer. You made the gold connection, and you've won a major prize. So, without further ado, let's tell you what you're going to be winning. This is it.
David of Runshaw College has won for himself a selection of sports gear, including squash racket, tennis racket, sports shoes, towel, and a sports hold-all.
Well, it's a good start. A good start, Dave. Are you a sporting man? I didn't ask you in the first time.
I play some tennis.
You play some tennis. You're going to have to spread your sporting activities, yes, aren't you? Well done. It was a very good go on the first run, but you know all too well how they build up. They start fairly small. They're major prizes, but they start fairly small. But when you get to 4 and 5, then things really begin to happen. OK, David, you get settled. We're going to meet somebody now who's going to challenge you in this. 2 more gentlemen, I do believe, who are coming onto the floor. So, without further ado, let's get going on the first game of the set of 3, but first we meet the next contestants on Blockbusters. Well, you sound like 2 of the Beatles, Paul and George, no relation, but which part of the country do you come from? Not Merseyside, sure.
Ruthin in North Wales.
Ah, yes, know it well. I've been there myself. What particular school?
Ruthin School.
And I know the school, right. OK, Paul and George, as always, we get a little bit about your interests, not only at school, but outside school as well. Are you sporting chaps, both of you?
Well, I play cricket and squash for the school. Mm-hmm. I play rugby with more enthusiasm than skill.
I see. Any particular type of rugby?
Rugby union.
Rugby union, I see. And what about school? What do you excel at? What are you superb at, George? You tell me.
Not a lot, really. Anything but French.
Anything but?
French.
I see. Like that, is it, Paul?
I suppose I'm okay at maths.
OK, well, that's a general picture. That's Paul and George. They haven't settled in yet. They obviously will be a little bit nervous to begin with, but let's give them the first game in the set of three to run in on. This is the board. They have to make that connection across the board, of course, blue to blue. That's Paul and George. And while they're doing that, it's David, who knows all too well he's got to make the connection top to bottom, white to white. Right, we start with the first game in a set of three on Blockbusters, and O is the letter. This is the one. Stand by your buzzers. What O is a pop group or a Greek poem about the wanderings of Ulysses?
Odyssey.
Odyssey is right. Yes, good start. OK, Dave?
C, please.
You want C. OK. What sea was the Roman goddess of corn who's given a name to... Yes, Paul?
Ceres.
Ceres is right, yes. And it's your choice.
B, please.
B? What B is a pair of pheasants or other game? That's George.
Brace.
Brace is right, good. Well, that's one each all the way along. Now what?
T, please.
T? Right. T to join the two up. What tea is a large Scottish berry with a pom-pom on top? That's George.
Tam O'Shanter.
Tam O'Shanter's right, yes. Yep.
J, please.
J. They're quick, aren't they, David? Here we go. Stand by your buttons. What J is a frill on the front of a woman's blouse or a man's shirt front? Yes, George.
Jersey. Jerkin.
Nope. I'll give it again, and this time it's for you, David. What J is a frill on the front of a woman's blouse or a man's shirt front? Odd word, it's a jabot, J-A-B-O-T. So we'll have another J. Why not? What J had a dream of a ladder going up to heaven? Ah, yes, David.
Jacob.
Jacob is right. Jacob's ladder, yes. And that gives you the choice.
L, please.
You want L down there on the bottom right. OK. What L was a dreaded disease in medieval times? Yes, George.
Leprosy.
Leprosy is right. Yes, good guess. M.
Okay. R, please.
You want R? Yes, right across the other side. To make the connection on the left. Make a collection if you wish, but there we are. What R is a part-time judge in a crown court? Or, yes, George?
Recorder.
Recorder's right, yes, good one. And as we all know, that flashing light means there's one unit to make the connection. Unless
D.
It's blocked by David, it's got to be yes.
D, please.
D. Okay, you're going to do it that way. Fair enough. What D is the disease that results from a deficiency of insulin? Paul got there.
Diabetes.
It is diabetes. That's the correction. Dave, isn't it infuriating when you actually know it and you get there and you found you've just been beaten at the post? You're both very quick indeed. Have you two been practicing on buttons?
We do a quiz program on the local radio station.
Oh, do you? I see. What sort of quiz program? General knowledge?
Yeah,
I mean, does it specialise in any particular?
It's just called Schools Challenge, and you get four people from each school and just have half an hour of general knowledge questions on the button.
And you're used to diving for that button, are you? So there's a bit of competition here. OK, well, we're going in for the second round. Dave, you've got to stay in this. You realise that to get the best of three. Here's the board for the second round. It's S that's blinking, and we'll see who comes out of this at the other end. First question. What S was a horse-drawn carriage or a county in southern England? Yes, David?
Stafford.
No, David. It goes to... I'll give you the whole answer first. What, the whole question first. What S was a horse-drawn carriage or a county in southern England?
Surrey.
Surrey, with a fringe on top? Absolutely, yes. It's your choice.
N, please.
You want M?
N for nuts.
N for nuts. Fine, that's over on the left. Here we go. What N is an island that's part of St. Kitts administratively? It was just too late. Yes, just too late. Time was up. What were you going to say out of interest?
New Hebrides.
No, it was Nevis. Nevis. N-E-V-I-S. Never mind. Here we go with another one. N. What N was the title taken by Alfred Harmsworth, who founded the Daily Mail? Yes, George?
Lord Northcliffe.
Lord Northcliffe is right. Yes, well done. Right, where now?
D, please.
D. Funny how many go for that pattern right the way across the board. What D is either a false shirt front or an extra seat? George?
Dickie.
Yes, Dickie it is, yeah. And a rueful grin from David, who got that one as well. OK, the next one.
F, please.
It's going to be F. They're moving fast. Stand by, Dave. What F is called a vendetta in Corsica? Yes?
Feud.
Yes, it is. That's well done, yeah. There they go again. What's next?
R, please.
R. OK. What R was the word meaning rebirth, which was used... That's Paul.
Renaissance.
Yes, Renaissance is right, yes. Yes, where now?
T, please.
T, right. What T is the name of the sign of the zodiac symbolized for?
Taurus.
Gosh, yes, that's right. Well, there's that flashing again. You're not giving us much time, are you? What are you going to pick this time?
M, please.
M? Watch it, David. This is it. What M is a metallic element that is liquid? It's Paul again.
Mercury.
Is the right answer, and that's it. Well, there we are. There isn't much to say. That practice has done you an enormous amount of good, hasn't it? You're going to be hard to displace. They've done very well. They've displaced our champion, who's sitting back there with a resigned look on his face. But you have got, of course, what is it, £60 and the tennis and squash kit. So it's worth coming on the programme, I hope. It's been our worth seeing you and knowing that we can send you off with a blockbuster sweatshirt and, of course, the leather-bound dictionary. David, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Bye-bye. Well, now our two friends from North Wales. One of you, and I think I'm right in this, isn't it you, George, plays low-level rugby?
Yes.
Now, what is low-level rugby?
Rugby with more more enthusiasm than skill, as I said.
Oh, is
I'm
it?
I'm not very good.
I see. You keep a low profile, do you? Is that what it's all about?
It's called supportive rugby. You don't touch the ball, but you get stuck in.
I see. Do you play rugby enthusiastically, Paul, or are you a non-rugby man?
It's a disgusting game.
I see. You don't like it at all.
No.
Let's find out now. Who is the captain, Paul or George? It's you. You're in the middle. And which one of you are going for the goal run?
Me.
It's you. How often it is that the captain nominates himself? It's very brave. Here, the board will be coming up very shortly, but not today. Because we're going to leave you for now in the balance, so to speak, as we wait for our new champions to take the gold run. And if they get through that one, as David did, then, of course, they stand a chance of going right up to the very top and taking, who knows, perhaps a round-the-world trip. We hope you'll join us next time to watch them take the gold run. For now, goodbye.
Have any conception what his actual family was doing?
There's people coming.
The dead can't hear us.
We'll kill every last man at Castle Black.
The Game of Thrones series finale, Monday at 9 on Sky Atlantic HD, or catch up on demand.
I do remember the moment when I was asked to be the funhouse man, yes. I was shortlisted to do the job with John Leslie, and it was myself and him who went for auditions in Glasgow, and we auditioned with two sets of girls, Melanie and Martina, who the twins became the funhouse girls.
We were up against these other girls. And actually, the floor manager at the time came up to us and she said,
girls, I think you've got it. And we were like,
secret squirrel.
But we weren't allowed to say anything.
Where we did the interviewing was on the top floor in the boardroom of this building. And the boardroom had a glass window to it. And when the lift came up, the lift would squeak. So we could hear the lift come to the top. And then when the lift doors opened, we could see into the lift before the person in the lift knew that we could see the person in the lift.
He sort of bounded in full of energy with the mullet and the pink tracksuit. And we both looked at each other and said, that's the one.
I remember more my audition, really, going in and making it, trying to make it be fun and bright, like my radio shows that I was doing at the time for Capital Radio. So I wanted it to be based. They told me that if the show went out and went to become a show, it would be on a Friday afternoon. So I ran on and went like, here comes the weekend. This is the way to kickstart your weekend, blah, blah, blah. And I made it really bright and energetic and entertaining and what I thought was right. So I think that's what helped get me the job.
Welcome along to the weekend. It all starts here on the Funhouse, and I'm Pat Sharp, and I'm going to make your house such a funhouse.
The twins were avid Neighbour fans.
They were totally, utterly and absolutely obsessed with Neighbours, the twins. I think they were 16 at the time, so, I mean, they were the right age to be obsessed with Neighbours. So when they came for their audition, they brought with them their own television set.
I thought, oh, that's a bit weird. And they said, oh, Anne, do you mind? The next episode's about to start. Could you wait?
Because the time we were going to interview them, they'll miss the episode of Neighbours. So we're having to wait for half an hour until they've seen the episode of Neighbours, and then they'll do their interview.
Ever after, wherever they went, in their dressing room, in the studios, in cow cabins, the twins and their television there watching the programme.
I quite enjoy watching it, and I'm really pleased it's back on Challenge. I'm so pleased, I'm so chuffed.
Yeah.
It's just lovely. It's nice.
Watching us jump up and down.
Yeah. I could show my little boy.
Oh, I know.
Look, there's Mummy being silly.
Bob Holness.
Thank you very much indeed. Thank you and welcome once again. You know, it's always difficult on an ongoing show like this, as they call them these days, to know where one leaves off the time before. I was about the only one just before we came on the air who couldn't remember. So we'll see if I've got it right as I ask our twin couple here, Christopher and Hayley, whether I'm right in believing that you've gone for a gold run already. We're into the second game of a set of three. And in fact, you want to win this game because you, Chris, I believe you said, have an ambition to win a quiz game like this, right?
Yes.
Yes, he says guardedly. Well, we'll see. Anyway, the only person that's going to stop him right now is going to be Jonathan because he's competing. And Jonathan, I believe, again, I'm right in saying that you've got to win this one to stay in the running.
Yes, that's right.
Okay, well, that's it. Second game of a set of three. Here's the board. Jonathan is white. He's going top to bottom. While the other two, of course, Christopher and Hayley, are going across blue to blue to make the connection. You can see C winking. That's because we had a C question last time. We passed over one, and it's time to start Blockbusters now by picking another C question. So let's play the game of Blockbusters. And here's the first question of the game. What C is a warm wind, an American Indian tribe, and a large helicopter? Christopher.
A Chinook.
Chinook is right. Good answer. And we're off. What do you want next?
H, please.
You want H? Okay. to make the connection on the left. What H, anybody, is the scratchy shirt one button... Yes, John?
Hair.
Hair shirt is right, yes. Your turn for the next one.
We'll have N,
you'll
please.
Have N, OK. Well pronounced. Here we go. What N is zero? Nothing. That's Haley.
Naught.
Naught is right, yes. You could have said nil, but I was going to say that next. So naught was the correct answer, and it gives you the pick.
L, please.
You want L, Haley? OK. Here we are. Whoops. Pick two out. Just the one will do. What L comes from sheep's wool and is used in the manufacture of hand cream? Yes, Haley.
Lanolin.
Is the right answer. Yes, very good. OK, now what?
T, please.
T? Making that connection right across. Let's see. What T is the Caribbean island near Venezuela? That's Christopher.
Trinidad.
Trinidad is right, yes. And before you say it should have been Tobago as well, I was going to say join politically to Tobago, so that's the correct answer. The flashing means you've almost made that connection. Jonathan, you've got to stop them here. Which one are you going to go for?
S, please.
Yes, S. This is the one. What S is a long story, especially one from Iceland? Chris?
A saga.
Saga is right. That's the connection. Well, I don't know. Hardly worth your coming, Jonathan, was it, really?
It's been fun.
It's a bit sad. It's been fun. You've enjoyed it,
yes,
haven't you?
Thank you.
How much money have you won? It's £30 now, isn't it?
Oh, I hope so. Yeah.
Yes, it is. £30 you'll walk off with, which is not bad. Plus, of course, the sweatshirt, the Blockbuster sweatshirt, and the leather-bound dictionary. So, Jonathan, it's been a pleasure. I hope you get on well with your entertaining, your piano
thank
playing,
you.
And your lessons. Thank you very much indeed for joining us.
Thank
cheers.
You.
Well, what we've got to remind ourselves of is which one of these two went for the gold run the first time. Tell me, I've forgotten.
I don't.
It was you, Haley, yes, mm-hmm. Which leaves you, Chris, to get down there on the spot. Just to tell you what you've got to face when you get there, let's see the board. Those are the multiple letters. There they are, all waiting for us, the multiple letters, and you've got to make that connection across the board, gold to gold, in a simple way like that, which is a minimum of five, or one of the more complicated ways, perhaps, like that. But as we all know by this time, don't we, Chris has to make it in exactly 60 seconds. Exactly 60 seconds, or less. But if he takes any longer at all, he doesn't make the connection, but he does get £10 for each of the correct answers. So, Chris, can we put you, please, on the hotspot? And as the lights dim, a quick reminder, you've got to make that gold-to-gold connection in 60 seconds or less. If you don't make it, you get £10 for each correct answer. And we take our timing from the moment you give me the initials you want to start with in the left-hand column. It's all yours.
MFJ.
Cash for conserve, an easy job.
Money for jam.
Yes.
H-O-R.
Lower part of US Congress.
House of Representatives.
Yes.
VS.
Bust, waist and hip measurements.
Vital statistics.
Correct.
BTM.
George Bernard Shaw play about the elderly.
Pass, LB.
Opera based on a book about Parisian artistic life by Puccini.
La Boheme.
Yes.
PB.
What the Admiral Graf Spee was.
Pocket battleship.
Yes, that's the connection. Congratulations, absolutely marvellous run across. You did it well within the time, Chris. So let's see what your second gold run's going to bring you.
And Chris and Haley have each won a weekend break in the home of the Bard at Stratford-upon-Avon. During the course of their stay, we'll provide tickets for a performance by the Royal Shakespeare Company at the famous Stratford-upon-Avon Theatre.
Well, that's a superb prize, and I do know that Haley particularly likes the spot of acting on the side. In fact, not so much on the side. You've done quite a lot, haven't you, Haley?
Well, in school plays and yes. In the local drama association. It's just started up.
It's a nice prize, isn't it? I think you'll enjoy
it. It's lovely,
that.
Yes.
There was one you didn't come up on, and that the answer to that one was Back to Methuselah, Back to Methuselah. But the rest of them you won right the way across. A good gold run, Chris. And it means that we are now going into another set of three games. They have that third gold run to get, and the prize builds up, of course. But before any of that, we've got to meet a new contestant. So let's see who it is. Who is next going to play Blockbusters? Simon, hello and welcome.
Good evening.
What's the badge, Simon, on the tie?
Led Zeppelin.
Is it really?
My favourite band, yes.
Oh, I see, I see. That's the badge on the tie, Led Zeppelin. I thought it might be a school
badge. Oh, sorry, on the tie. Ah. I thought you meant the old lapel.
Oh, I see, you've got another one over the other side. You're covered in
the package. No, this is the school tie.
I thought it might just be, yes. The school being where?
And school boot.
School boot, I see. White boots. They all wear white boots.
Oh, yes.
Ah, interesting, yes.
Spilsby, renowned for it, yeah.
Mm. Spilsby?
Yes.
That's in Lincolnshire?
Lincolnshire.
Yes, I thought so.
North of Watford.
Mm. Well, that's some, do I? We now know all there is to know, yes. I can see we're going to have a bit of fun, Simon. What particular topics are you interested in outside school?
Outside of school?
Yeah.
I like travelling and I want to meet people.
Yes, yes, yes.
No, seriously.
No, seriously, yes.
I'm a drummer in a local band.
You're not.
I am.
Good heavens.
Yes.
You do realise he's a hit to heavy metal next to you there. And
yes.
You do realise that she actually likes pop music and plays the violin. Look, if you stay on for a couple of nights, do you think you can all bring the instruments along and have a little session? It would be quite pleasant, wouldn't it? Okay. You want to be a drummer? Is this one of your things?
Well, I suppose so, yes, if the opportunity comes up.
Why not?
Why not?
Absolutely. Well, I should think there's no lacking in confidence for Simon. I think he's all ready to start the game. So, shall we move to the board now to see what the letters are? There they are, staring us in the face. So, Simon, Chris and Hayley, stand by the buttons as we play another game of Blockbusters. And it's the letter C that starts us off. Here we go. What C is what parents do at babies and pigeons...
Christen?
Yeah. No, you don't christen at a person, but never mind. I will complete the question to the other two. It was well interrupted. Chris and Hayley, what C is what parents do at babies and pigeons do in general?
Coo.
Yes, it is. Coo, Christopher. Well done. Good start. So, here we go. What's the next one?
S, please.
You want S? Okay. What S is a North Yorkshire resort whose fair...
Scarborough.
Scarborough is right, yes. Well done. Poor old Simon and Garfunkel didn't get a move in. Anyway, what's the next one?
I'll have an A, please, Bob.
You'll have an A. Right. What A is the fruit of the oak? Yes, Chris?
Acorn.
It's got to be acorn, yes. That's the correct one. You get the next one, won't you, Simon?
Oh, yes.
Yes, of course you will. Okay, now, what's the next letter?
V, please.
V? You've got to get it soon, I'll tell you that. What V was an explorer and is the largest port in the Pacific coast of Canada? Chris?
Vancouver.
Is right, Vancouver, yes. One to go unless Simon blocks it. What's it going to be?
R, please.
You're going for R. Great decision there. Here we are. What R is a form of football first played... Yes, Hayley?
Rugby.
It's got to be rugby, yes, that's it. And that's how it's played, really, Simon, you see? It's sort of goes across the board, just like that. Do you think you can do that next time round?
No comment.
And I'm not surprised. Right, that means one game in the set of three, and quite seriously, it is Simon who needs to get the next game to stay in the running. There's a gold run in the offing, but we won't be doing any of that, of course, for just a minute, because we're taking a break. See you soon.
Freedom for the taking. Blue e-cigarettes and e-liquids.
Make this summer a summer of flavour and make the Great British Summer even greater. Spiced lamb and pomegranate fire bread. Blackcurrant and vanilla layered dessert. And a free bottle of wine when you buy four selected picnic items. Make summer delicious.
Gallery, we'll be there in 5 minutes. We can be live as soon as we get there. Sign you?
We're trying, Ronan, we're trying.
Could I have IFB down this line, please?
Sorry, I've got it, actually.
I can't hear you.
I'm having to do the camera myself.
How long to us?
Come to us as quickly as you can.
Stand by, stand by. You can work with it, can you?
OK, here we go.
Tell us the full story, Dominic.
Stand by, OS2.
He comes to you now. I can get you in, please.
This is turning absolutely chaotic now.
Go on.
I've just got a breaking line through.
Surely you should resign.
We're currently being detained by the police.
Class bombs.
You've already seen his press.
I'm amazed they let us film that.
Just finishing the edit now.
So I'll let you know when that's better.
And welcome back, and we start the second half of the show exactly as we started the first half, if you recall, into the second game of a set of three. And the situation is roughly similar too. Christopher and Haley have one game, one already, and it is Simon in this case who has to win the next game to stay in the running. He looks as though he's going to make everybody north of Watford very proud of him by doing that, and Christopher and Haley have that determined and confident look of a pair of winners who've been in there for some time, and that could be dangerous. Let's see the board, shall we? This is the board for the next one. The letter flashing is A, so here we go with the second game in this set of three, and here's the question. What A is rung at morn, noon, and sunset? Morn, noon, and sunset. Angelus is the answer to that. I'm so glad I got one right for change. Here we go now. What A are mountains that form a range entirely in Italy? Yes, Haley.
Alps.
No, Haley. I'll have to give that one to Simon. Here's your chance, Simon. What A are mountains that form a range entirely in Italy?
The Apennines.
Apennines is right! Yay! dear me, what's the next one?
V, please.
Oh, is there no end to any of this? That's that sound which means that the contestant which gets this question right wins a prize for the school. Yes, it's your chance, Simon, to win a prize for the school. We'll find out what it's going to be in a minute. The question first, for anybody, what V is a doctor for animals? Simon!
A vet!
Yes, it is! And a prize for the school as well. No, it's not fixed, it's just the way it's happened. So let's find out what prize, and it's going to be a pretty good one, the school is going to win. This one.
And Simon has won for King Edward VI School this magnificent refractor telescope. Any potential astronomers will now have the opportunity to explore the wonders of the sky at night.
Smashing prize. Yeah. Do you astron?
No.
You don't astron
no.
at all?
No. I believe there's one in the whole school. Robert Renton, if you're looking, Robert.
I know. I believe one of the two other contestants does astronomy. Well, likes astronomy. Is it you, Hayley?
Yes.
You would have liked that prize, wouldn't you? Should have pressed the button quicker. Sorry. Right. Your choice, Simon. What's next?
H, please, Bob.
H. Right. Here we go. They're sending me up, you know. What H was a kind of woman's figure or is an ancient method of telling the time? Yes, Haley.
Hourglass.
Hourglass is right. Well done. Yeah. Your choice.
O, please.
You want O. What O is the organization which governs the price of Middle East? Yes, Haley.
OPEC.
OPEC is right, yes. And the next.
M, please.
M. Right. Here we go. What M is a significant line through Greenwich? Simon?
Wouldn't be mean, would it?
No, it wouldn't.
Sorry.
I can see why you thought so. I've got to give the question to the other two. The M, which is a significant line through Greenwich.
Meridian.
Meridian is right. That's what we were looking for. Good try. What's the next one?
W, please.
W at the bottom there. What W is the common name for the track here? Yes, Haley?
Windpipe.
Yes, it's windpipe. Yes. Well, it looks as though only one is needed to make the connection for the second time. Your last chance to stop them, Simon. Which one's it going to be?
R, please.
You want R? She says in hushed tones. What R is a large bag worn on the back by hikers? Yes, Simon?
A rucksack.
Rucksack is right. Dear me. What's the next choice,
then? N, please, Bob.
You want N. Okay. Yes. What N was that Derek, whose life began at 40? That was Haley.
Nimmo.
Yes, Nimmo's right, yes. And it's your choice again.
F, please.
F. Okay, down at the bottom left. What F is used for the tips of pens and for making... Yes, Simon?
Felt.
Felt is right. Good. Where now, Simon?
S, please.
Okay. S. What S was a tube-like dress of the early 50s or a cloth container for potatoes? Yes, Hayley?
Sack.
Sack is right, yes. And it's your choice for the next one.
C, please.
You want C to join up that lot over there. What sea finished an historic mission in the Pacific Ocean on July the 24th, 1980? Like this question. Columbia, spacecraft, remember? Ditched in the sea. Fine. Next C. What sea is a sort of engineering, a sort of servant, and a sort of disobedience? Hayley.
Civil.
It's got to be civil, yes. Giving you another chance to have one more to make that connection, unless it can be blocked. Which is it going to be?
T, please.
Yes, thought it might be T. Here we go. What T is the lever fitted to the head of the rudder of a small boat? Yes, Simon.
A till. Tiller.
Tiller is right, yes. Woo-hoo. And what?
B, please, Bob.
B. You devil. What B? What B comes after Burlington and before Worcester? Yes, Hayley.
Bertie.
Bertie is right. Yes. We're using up all the units on the board. What's the next one?
G, please.
G you'll go for rather than J. This is the G which could win you the game. Watch it. What G is the film in which Ben King... Yes, Chris?
Gandhi.
Gandhi is right, and that's it. Heavens, it was a good try, wasn't it? My goodness.
Did my best.
A very good battle, that. You've actually won for the school that superb telescope.
Yeah, I hope they appreciate it.
I hope they do, yes. Do you think they will?
I think so, yes.
You think so, good. Well, at least it'll put you in well for them for the next few months, won't it? Yes. £25 as well, you get. You mustn't forget, must we? You not only take the telescope, the £25, you also get the sweatshirt, the Blockbuster sweatshirt, which you can wear all over North Watford.
And the dictionary.
And the dictionary, which is leather-bound and gold-blocked. What more could you ask?
Oh.
Simon, thank you very much.
Thank you.
we don't have too many of them. Well, now, Chris and Hayley, it's their turn now to do another gold run. It's the third gold run. Just to check, they've won binoculars and a camera and a holiday in Stratford already for each of them. And it's now going to be you, Hayley, isn't it, to come down and do the gold run?
Yes.
Yes. Filled with trepidation?
Yes.
It might be. Here's the board. That's what's going to confront you when you get onto that hot spot. Those are the letters. Just to recap very briefly, you've got to make the connection across the board, gold to gold, like that. It can be done simply, or it can be done in a more complicated way, like that, perhaps. And you've got to do it within 60 seconds or less. So, if you're ready, Hayley, for the second time, for you, will you please join us on the hotspot? Necessary, once again, for me to tell you, the connection must be made in 60 seconds or less. For every connection that's not made, you get £10 for each correct answer. And I take my timing from the moment you tell me which letters you want to start with on the left-hand side. All yours, Hayley.
L-S.
A celestial body that gives good fortune to the newly born.
Pass, C-A-C-C.
Form of wrestling.
Pass, R-T-W.
What the hand that rocks the cradle does.
Pass, C-A-M.
Shellfish that Molly Malone sells in Dublin's Fair City.
Cockles and mussels.
Correct.
C-C.
Small present and bang wrapped in paper. Small present and bang wrapped in paper.
Pass, I-T-S-B.
All occupying the same vehicle.
In the same boat.
Correct.
J-N.
First Premier of Tanzania.
Joshua Nkomo.
No.
A-T-A.
David Bowie's song title reminds us of a funeral.
Ashes to Ashes.
Correct.
J.B.
Hanged in 1859 for trying to stop slavery by force.
Pass, L.M.
From New Moon to New Moon.
Lunar Month.
Right.
K.E.
Hero of romance, satirized by Cervantes and copied by Don Quixote. Terrifyingly hard luck. You almost made it. Would you have known Hero of Romance, satirized by Cervantes and copied by Don Quixote?
No.
Knight errant, it would have been. Never mind. You missed out on quite a few across the board. Let's have a quick look at them. The celestial body that gives good fortune to the newly born is Lucky Star. That was an easy one, wasn't it? Form of wrestling, catch as catch can. You got Molly Malone. What the hand that rocks the cradle does is rules the world. It's a well-known saying. CC, small present and bang, wrapped in paper, a Christmas cracker. JN, the premier, was not one you said, but it was Julius Nyerere. And JB, hanged in 1859 for trying to stop slavery by force, John Brown. And, of course, the hero of the romance, Knight Errant. Well, there you are. Let's play another game of blockbusters. Well, it was hard luck, but, of course, she did add to her total of wins across the board, £40 onto their total, bringing it up now to £230 each, which is very good because you have to add it onto the presents they've received so far. Oh, well, it's quite exhausting. They've got through three gold runs. They've got two more to go if they can get there. The person who perhaps will stop them is the person we're going to meet next on Blockbusters. Hello, Richard. While they battled it about, you've been waiting in the wings to come on.
That's right.
How are you feeling?
Oh, not too bad. Little nervous, I think.
Yeah, well, everybody does, first of all. Where do you come from, Richard?
Well, I come from Quinton Kyniston School, which is in St John's Wood.
Ah, so you didn't have far to come to this particular
thing. Not really.
And you, do you specialise in any particular subject?
Oh, well, I'm sort of in the arts, English, history, economics. Mm.
What about recreation? What do you do?
Oh, recreation. I like ballet, I like dancing, I like reading. Mm. I like cooking, I like most things.
You don't mind any chance to play drums in a band or anything like that?
No, I'm afraid not.
It's something of a relief, I find that. Richard, welcome to the programme.
Thank you.
Christopher and Haley, if you're ready, we'll play now the first in a new set of three Blockbusters. And one of those lights will be winking now, which will tell us which letter we're going to start with. It's P, so here we go. What P is a bird whose beak holds more than his belly can? Yes, Richard?
Pheasant?
Nope, I was passed it across. Well interrupted. What P is a bird whose beak holds more than his belly can?
Pelican.
Pelican is right. That's it. Haley, well done. And what's your choice?
T, please.
It's T. What T is Channel 4's pop music programme, or... Yes, Haley.
Tube.
Tube is right. Yes, well done. Richard knew that as well, but he's got to be quicker than that. What's the next choice?
K, please.
You want K. So, what K is merely a male monarch? That's Haley again.
King.
It is King. That's the right one. Got to stop her, Richard. You know that.
Yeah, I will.
Okay. What's the next choice?
F, please.
You want F? Okay. What F is a Scottish, American, or dialect for tap? Is Scottish, American, or dialect for tap? Yes, Haley.
Fawcett.
Yes, Fawcett is right. Well done. Well, one to go to get that connection across the board. Which one are you going to go for?
I'll have an A, please, Bob.
You'll go for A, okay? Yes. Important one, this. Stand by your buttons. What A is a tune or what we breathe? Haley.
Air.
Air is right. That's the connection. Well, that shows you how it's done, Richard. It's, as I said to the gentleman before you, it can be very quick, but it can be a pitched battle. You've got settled in now, haven't you?
Yes.
You're going to shine in the second round, aren't you?
You better believe it, Bob.
Well, you're not going to have the chance to find out, not today at any rate, because that's where we're going to leave you for now, because we've come to the end of this particular one. Going to be interesting, because Richard has actually got to win the next game to stay in the running, and I've got a sneaky feeling about it. I think we're going to find it pretty exciting. We hope you can join us. We'll certainly be here. See you soon. Bye-bye.
With age, we get better at lots of things. We take more risks. A lot more. In a word, we improve.
Vitalify from L'Oreal Paris. One step, five actions to target the appearance of wrinkles, firmness, dryness and discomfort.
Skin feels smoother, firmer and looks revitalized.
Vitalify from L'Oreal Paris Men Expert.
There is no excuse for letting go.
And now there's no excuse for forgetting this Father's Day.
When I met you in the summer.
What was the last adventure you took your family on? What will be the next?
In the summer.
Are you ready to live?
Oh, yeah!
This summer, Sky Movies brings you the biggest family hits in a non-stop journey that starts whenever you're ready on demand.
We'll become closer as a family.
Awesome! Summer. To upgrade, go to skymovies.com/addmovies.
Well, I think the first one must have taken a good 2.5 hours to record. Somebody wasn't pressing the right switches, or maybe the plug wasn't in the right place.
A lot of these game shows had gone from being very kind of, you know, card graphics to becoming computer graphics. And Wipeout was one of the first ones where we'd integrated that kind of technology into the set, which, for very obvious reasons, had its own problems, you know.
And as you will know, but if you won't, what happens is you have run-throughs before, and it's not technical at all. The electronic board is a girl holding a sign up, and because it was quite a fast-paced show as well, seeing the girls scrabbling for the right board to hold up, and of course, if you remember Wipeout, it had that grid, so we had all these boards drawn up and all that, and it was very funny. And ever since I've wanted to do a game show on TV where there's no set, where there's no technicals, where we've got people, maybe from the audience, holding up signs, you know, this is the score and all that. And you could get a lot of comedy out of that. That would be great.
So the set itself was really, really complex. And what you would get was the old problem. It's a bit like with any building. The guys who built the set would build the set over the wires, and the wires would get broken, and therefore the technology wouldn't work, and, you know, we had to dig the set up to repair the cables and stuff like that. So there's a lot of those kind of things going on. It was a bit of a nightmare.
When it's edited, it looks very smooth, but in what you don't know is that the performer, the presenter, is doing jokes about who's getting it wrong and shouting off things like, how long have you worked here, not counting tomorrow, you know, and stuff like that. You know. And it was, what an odd way to hand his notice in. Look at that, you know. And I think we even had, which doesn't happen often, in the studios, as you know, you have these big lights, and we even had one of them explode. Bang, you know. And, but it did cure the constipation on the audience.
What are these couples running from? They're not. They're running to